We are the 100%. We are united, and we will not settle. Autism does not end at war.
First, I just wanted to say shame on this government for doing this now when it's so cold outside. The thing that we would not come here and protest, but we did them wrong.
Where are you?
I am not here fighting just for my children, but for all our children. The kids with no voice until they have a voice.
I am here to beg the Ford government to reconsider investing our children now, because the cost is so much higher if we don't.
I had hopes for their futures. But that was all stolen away.
Mr. MacLeod and Premier Ford have been using to hoodwink the MPPs, the media, and the public into believing that the changes in funding are for the benefit of those on the wait list. The changes the government is making to the funding for therapy is increased mental health concerns both now and in the future.
Autism doesn't end at 5, it doesn't end at 55,000, and it doesn't end at 18.
We will be paying at the expense of her quality of life. The government doesn't seem to understand.
It means loss for everyone.
Now, every day, I look at my children and I wonder,
is this the only option the government has? Will those on the wait list benefit from the changes? Has the government consulted with stakeholders in good faith? No! It takes us down a road that leads to significant burdens, with a sense of helplessness and hopelessness and struggle. It means a burden on an education system that is already under-resourced and ill-equipped to support the level and number of children with special needs. Let teachers be teachers. Let parents.